Illustrator 2026 just launched, and I'm here to tell you everything you need to know about the new version. Starting with the coolest feature by far, we have the turntable effect. However, this one's actually only available on the beta version of Illustrator, despite showing on the update pop-up for the new stable version. The new turntable effect is an AI feature that lets us rotate a 2D vector illustration like it was 3D. It's available by selecting the vector artwork, then going to the Object menu, Generative, and Turntable. Once selected, the effect will process for a minute or two, and then you'll be able to drag the slider to rotate around the object. This is a pretty cool effect, and I managed to get some good results. But sometimes things get a bit wonky and distorted, which is expected for both a beta and an AI feature. I guess at the stage the effect is right now, it really depends on the vector you use. Some will turn out fine, while others not so much. You can also use these up and down arrows to shift the view of the vector upwards and downwards. Gradients also received some attention on this update, with two very cool new features. The first one is the option to add dithering to the gradient to avoid bending. If you have no clue what the heck I just said, bending in a gradient happens when there aren't enough colors between the two colors selected to create a smooth transition, so you see these ugly lines. Dithering comes into play to solve this issue. Dithering is a sort of noise texture used to hide such imperfections, being something commonly used, for example, as a shading technique for pixel art. If you zoom in very close to a gradient using dithering, you can see the noise pattern hiding the lines created by the bending, and the result is actually really, really good. Nice to finally see this feature here. The other new feature is a new method for blending the colors in a gradient. You can see this drop-down menu with the classic option selected, which are the gradients we're used to, but now we have this new perceptual option, which is supposed to blend colors in a way that's more natural to our eyes. Or, in other words, in a way we would expect one color to shift into another. To be honest, I'm not sure if I really would expect colors to blend any differently than they currently do, but hey, as long as it's an option and we can still use the old one, I'm fine with it. What I noticed is that this new gradient mode kinda avoids using a third color to make the transition, as you can see here when I select purple and yellow. Usually we would get this sort of pink in the middle, but now it just transitions from purple to yellow without this third color in the middle, almost going to a white or gray to make the transition. I also noticed this effect tends to make gradients lighter, and the difference is way more noticeable when we use very saturated colors that are very far apart in the color wheel, like purple and yellow, or red and blue. Artboards also got a bit of attention on this update. However, to make use of any of the new features, we need to have the artboard tool selected. With the tool on hand, we can now change the color of the artboard. That's right, no more creating rectangles to paint the artboard any color. Just select the artboard and change the background color using either the properties panel or the options bar. Another new feature is that the right-click menu now has relevant options for managing artboards, such as duplicating, deleting, renaming, creating new artboards, and even locking them. Locked artboards can't be selected with the artboard tool, but we can still draw on them as usual. A downside is that there is no option to unlock the artboards from the right-click menu, so we need to go to the artboards panel to do so. Selecting artboards has become more powerful as well, with the option to rearrange selected artboards separately and also exporting selected artboards through the right-click menu. The export window will show up with only the selected artboards marked for export. We also have new snapping options, snap to tangent and snap to perpendicular. Snap to tangent is especially useful for curved lines. You can think of a tangent as the direction a curve is pointing at in each specific point of the curve. Now, when both the direction of a straight line and the tangent of a curve are aligned, the mouse cursor will snap in that spot. This is particularly useful to converge a curve into a straight line in a way that feels natural and smooth. Snap to perpendicular is used only for straight lines, and it snaps when a line intersects with another at a 90 degrees angle. Both options of snapping can only happen at the endpoint of the line, so no way to snap the midpoint. The font selector window received a few small updates, but nothing too groundbreaking. A few new filter options have been added, and we can also view fonts saved on our libraries now. Other than that, options and buttons have mostly just been reorganized, with display options being moved to this gear icon. Images generated with Adobe Firefly can all be accessed straight inside Illustrator. If we select the Place option on the File menu and then select the Place from Adobe Cloud option, we can browse all the files we have saved on our Adobe Cloud, including images generated with Firefly. After selecting all the files we want, we can hit Place and click on the artboard to place them. Sadly, this doesn't mean we'll get to generate these images inside Illustrator yet. We can now create collaborative projects inside Illustrator. On the home screen, a new option called Projects is now available, where we can create and share projects for other people to interact with. You can add folders, images and files, manage who gets access and if they can just fill or edit as well, and save Illustrator files straight to that project's folder. Lastly, a feature that kinda got me excited for a brief second. Illustrator now has a template option on the home screen, which is integrated with Adobe Express. So I obviously thought we would be able to import Express templates into Illustrator. But it just opens Express on the browser with that template on a new project. Kinda useless. And that's all the relevant features for Illustrator 2026. Not gonna lie, that was a bit underwhelming. What did you think? If you enjoyed this video, check this other one here. A special thanks to all my Patreon supporters who help me make high quality content like this one. More on how you can support the channel in the description down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you have any doubts. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye!